De voksede rigtig, rigtig meget fra de startede og så til de sluttede.
First Lego League offers an inspirational and engaging way of learning. Miriam, Jakob, Kirsten and Mitch share their experiences.
As kids participate in project-oriented activities in First Lego League, they're learning concepts like mechanical advantage and programming ideas. They're learning practices of becoming a good designer and a good problem solver. And they're learning new perspectives, new ways to see themselves as a designer, and new ways of looking at the world and understanding the world around them.
The process involves research and product design, as well as robot construction and programming. The children go through development phases that teach them valuable science, technology, engineering, math, and life skills.
Jeg får kammeratskab ud af det, og jeg får brugt min viden, og jeg bliver også meget mere koncentreret, når jeg arbejder med sådan nogle ting. Jeg kunne ikke finde ud af at lave pyromatik, da jeg startede, og nu kan jeg det næsten helt i hovedet, og så kommer de andre altid over til mig. Kan du ikke lige hurtigt lave det her pyromatik til robotten, og så, ja, så fikser jeg det hurtigt.
Når så man har sin egen.
Ja. Man lærer at være mere fri, komme med sine meninger, og tænke i andre baner, end hvad man er vant til.
Altså, det var så meningen, at det her ur skulle måle det her.
One thing that I really like about the First Lego League activities is that kids are acting as designers. And when you're a designer, it's not just about designing a technology, but designing a technology for someone, having an audience in mind. Designers are always thinking about who's going to be using this, how will they be using it. So it's not just thinking about the technology, but about this interaction between a person and the technology. One of the reasons it's so important to make physical things is it then sparks conversation among all the people standing around it.
Ja, det er faktisk ekstremt god idé at sætte nogle hjul der.
Sæt hjul på det.
So it's not so much the looking at the object, but the interactions among all the people who are then looking at the object together.
Altså på siderne.
Ja.
It gives you things to talk about, and it gives you a more explicit way to talk about things. When they create a robot and tell the robot how they want it to behave, it's a way of taking their own thinking and putting it out in the world and trying it out, and sort of testing out their ideas. So when they write a program to control their Lego Mindstorms robot, they're actually taking sort of a piece of their mind, putting it into the robot, and seeing whether their idea really works out the way that they expected it to. And if the robot doesn't behave the way that you expected it to,
single,
it tells you there's some problem with your idea, there's a bug in your idea, but it then gives you an opportunity to not just fix the robot, but to fix your ideas.
Man vokser rigtig meget mentalt. Man sætter flere ting i perspektiv. Man lærer at se tingene fra andre folks perspektiv end ens eget. Tage kritik til sig og rent faktisk gøre noget ved det. Og man har det hyggeligt med dem, man arbejder sammen med.